Okay, we're going to do a truss rod adjustment on this 1951 reissue of a Fender P bass. This would be the first solid body production bass guitar that was presented to the world by Mr. Leo Fender. Anyway, we're going to do a truss rod adjustment on this guy. The actual little nut thing is hidden down in there, so I'm going to show you my trick for getting at that without killing yourself and wrecking the guitar and all that. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to loosen off the strings, and then I'm going to take, where did I do with it? Hold on, I got to find that. Some guys use a capo for this. I use a good old piece of surgical tube. So what we're going to do is we're going to wrap it around the strings when they're loose. That way they won't all come flopping off the tuning pegs. So that's like totally overkill. You could probably use about a tenth of that. But anyway, that's the idea. So now all the strings, when I remove the neck, we'll all stay in the tuning pegs, and then I'll be able to put the neck back on real quick, and that'll be that. So here we go. Okie doke. So we got to loosen the four screws on the back of the guitar to get the neck off. So there's the guy there that we're going to tighten up, but you can see that this allowed me to pop the neck off, but see, everything stayed in there, which is what we all want. We're going to give the truss rod about a quarter turn tighten, and we're going to put the neck back on real quick, and then play it. Cool, rocking. Okay, cool. That worked out great. So now the neck is nice and straight. It was probably okay. There was a little bit of more relief, more curve than I like. I like to play with a really straight neck. So now we're going to plug it in. This is a Japanese, crafted in Japan, Fender. It's pretty cool. Okay, here it is. Tons of tone on this thing. Isn't that great? Plays pretty nice too. Single coil pickup. See you next time. Cheers, folks.